Hi friends and everyone, I didn't write much script, but whatever week or 2 weeks gap, so whatever points I remember, I would like to speak out. Some subscribers, they have asked me, Kumar, what is the situation after COVID-19, either US or globally? I've been following the news, that is India News Telugu, especially Professor K. Nageswar Rao, heads of my sister gave this Rakhi. Rakhi is an Indian festival, and where the brothers and sisters, it's a love they express, right? And Ganesh Chaturthi is one of the Hindu calendar first festival that is celebrated by Hindus across the globe. And Muslim brothers, Eid Mubarak or all belated wishes. And students, good luck, for especially those who are aiming for F1 visa. That's one. And I started my blogs, kumarexclusive.com. Earlier I have a site, and that I don't want to go in details. So a friend, someone who associated with me or affiliated, dismantled that website. So then I thought of kumarexclusive.com. If you see, I put all the links to YouTube and Facebook and Twitter. Somebody wrote an email, or people write emails asking opinion on Joe Biden or President Trump, whoever, elections. So I write whatever. But I cannot write in detail, right? All my opinions, because my opinions or views on various topics already shared on Twitter and Facebook or wherever social media. So I'm a free thinker, I'm open-minded, and my knowledge is zero, except whatever I'm exposing in H1B is also very my tip of the iceberg. So I'm a last bench student, so there is nothing great to claim from my side. So that is about me. And go to that blog. Every day I will be writing, and somebody is passing by. So I wrote at least 5 p.m. if I started yesterday writing. I made it up to 3 a.m. So somebody from India corrected my English, the titles. Thank you very much. And that's about the blog. So I love writing. My English is not bad, not good, because my first language is Indian languages, second language also Indian languages, right? Telugu, Hindi, and third language is English. So you can understand my English. Yeah, that's all about me. And cheerful, because some haters also said, Kumar, please laugh or smile. And I watched a couple of videos, private videos. Ravi told him that upload it, but I'm not sure how far it is good to go in public. That's one. And I enjoy sometimes watching those videos. And that is one. And another one video is, I did a belly dance. I learned belly dance in Montana for 6 months. I learned various dances, but I'm not a dancer again. Like I said, several videos, I'm not an immigration attorney, I'm not a journalist, but I'm telling, advising this like that, right? So when I go through a lot of stuff on my laptop, then I've seen a lot of subscribers from 2011 to 15 or up to 16 helped Kumar Exclusive in doing research, or you call investigation, or whatever, man, the term used. Because they're all from various parts of, they're Indians, but they're all various parts of the world. They are not in India. Of course, some of them are in India. They sent emails, calls, and these Indian consultancies also called them for H-1B filing visas. See, any topic I take at the end, I'll come to H-1B, because a lot of emails I receive victims' emails, voice, and over the email or the phones. That's all about H1B, right? F1 or various scams that are going on by Indians here. So they received a lot of emails from these scam body scams, body shop scammers. I put all their screenshots there. So there are different styles. They're asking money for training purpose. They take cash and some expert in name, so ex person name, so they don't have any evidence. Like that, Indians are doing scam and crimes here, and Indian hiring managers also affiliated with these scammers, or sometimes the scammers become immigration attorneys, scammers become hiring managers, scammers become whatever. So you have to be very careful. I'm not against India or Indians or America or Americans. I love human beings because we all breathe same air and blood is red, is the bottom line. So that's why when I feel that, have that feeling when I'm talking to a person in Pakistan who is trying for F1 visa or K visa or Bangladesh or India or Singapore or South Africa, I feel that why should I have a separate identity as a caste, region, religion, like that, right? Of course, languages we speak for communication. We don't need to, for example, I speak Telugu, and in one client location, if you kick out all non-Telugu speakers, that's not good, right? That is what I'm exposing, confronting. I never exposed anybody individually, like some X wrong, Y wrong, like that. But body shops I can't hide, right, the names. And body shops also, they came on dependent visas, H4 visa, someone F1, someone H1. Once get green card, they are doing all kinds of fraudulent things. That's why Americans are afraid to give green cards to 800,000 Indians. H1B is waiting for green card. Again, I am not against India, Indians or H1B. I am only exposing the crime in H1B. That is the bottom line you have to remember. Disagreeing crime is not anti-India or anti-human, right? That's what, and I am only trying to protect the good image of the Indians abroad. Is what Americans are writing. See, like I said, English is my third language, so any statement that I take it, I will put in inverted commas, right? In Indian standard, we call inverted commas, quotes. So if it is mine, I will put hyphen KE. And anybody asking money for H1B or F1 visa, anything, H1B visa, especially jobs and visas, you call me. And I don't have any friends, because truth has no friends. Friends means I have a lot of friends, but I don't claim they are my partners, or neither of them, right? So vice versa, because some guys in the past cheated subscribers, collecting $10,000 from 12 subscribers. He believes in Jesus, so what? He cheated, right? So that is what. And these all, and one of my ex-colleagues in India, he sent one video. This is around 2 hours, and the third part is another 1 hour, 45 minutes, whatever. So 3 hours I watched that video. And it's about late Sri P.V.R.K. Prasad, IAS officer. We used to call DG sir, and anybody, my family members, elders call me from India, I never get up and speak, though I love them. But when this DG sir came to US, he called me, and this IAS officer, I was suddenly stand up from the bed and talking to him. I gave him that much respect and love, and I don't see where is God. I don't say I don't believe, but sometimes the doctors and these honest IAS officers appears as a God, in the form of a God. They are human beings, but God might send them to do some good work to the people, is what I believe when I see that IAS officer. I have associated with him almost for 5 years, so I can speak a lot about his honesty, integrity, and the service he did. But already those IAS officers, K.V. Ramanachari is also very honest IAS officer, and V.V. Lakshmi Narayan, people call J.D. Lakshmi Narayan IPS, he was there, we presented in that meeting, and some Swamiji's came, and Srimati PVRK Prasad's Madam Ji is also there in the meeting. So I was really so sad or depressed because I was associated with him and he's no more, but still I don't feel like he's still there. So that unable to digest. So that kind of what you call state of mind, like he's no more, but you can't digest that word no more, right? So that is how it is in Telugu. I can explain in my mother tongue very better. It is not that English language doesn't have that words. It might be, I may not know, right? I may not be or well in articulate. And Telugu, I would have cried by this time if I explain in Telugu. So that is one. That is on the weekend. So then, yeah, life is journey and. He is a spiritual man. I learned lot of things from him. And K.V. Ramanachari, that IAS officer, why I said honest. Generally, I don't give honest certificate to many people because I did lot of investigative kind when I was in government in India also, right? So, yeah, water bottle fell down. So, one day, I don't want to reveal a lot of details, but one of the friend's father's house has to be all loans go off. He took a loan from government, all installments, EMIs he has paid, but the officer in charge from a particular department is not signing it. If he sign and give a copy, then he will get a certificate, the house belongs to him, but he is not signing it. He wants bribes and harass him. Even if you pay bribes also, government staff harass in India, not all but majority. I have quoted that example earlier, but I will also explain again. So that is when I went to India, the cab driver is asking me, sir, I paid money when his newly born baby girl born, but still they are not giving the birth certificate. Why, sir? He paid bribes. For 1 week they ask him to roam. So that's sadism basically. When it comes to this example, I went to Ramanachari's officer's room, and we call room, right? But in US context it's called office. They don't call room. It's a big room. And he said, yeah, Kumar, what happened? Then I said, this person is not signing, sir. Then he called in front of me that officer, and he said, because he is the head of the department in the state, he said, sign it, why are you harassing? Then that person signed on the phone when this officer is there, and Kelkatam. So hats off. I don't know, see, for your information, I am most ordinary common man. Like, though I worked in government for 5.5 years, you can imagine I'm though my designation is gazetted officer, whatever, I'm the least driver kind or pune, how they work, that kind of work I did, I felt like that. I don't feel that I'm an officer or I'm whatever. With that stature or stature or whatever, with that designation or whatever the term, do you think I can manage IAS officers? No, right? Do you think they will allow me inside? First of all, IAS officers are arrogant and bossy, just like green card holders here. Not all, but only a majority. But still, that person is receiving the application, right? Irrespective of the caste, color and creed. That's why very few honest officers are there. I have to name for the public Dr. I.V. Subbarao, sir. He is IAS, and I worked under his guidance in when he was TTD. I don't know, Americans or others will understand this. Tirupati is something like a Vatican City and Makkah for Muslims, right? There's something like that. Tirupati is for Hindus. I worked there. It's a divine coincidence, and he was there, this IAS officer. So I told him when he moved to Hyderabad. So very few honest, that names, why I'm telling, they're all honest. And there is a criticism also, but I don't want to tell in this video because people spread rumors what is there, and they ask and they cross-check and validate, whatever. And but that's how, and we're all associated and affiliated with that gentleman, and it's a wonderful journey of life. And for a minute I was thinking why I'm in America, because I led a wonderful life in India, in Hyderabad, India. That's a golden era of my career, 1999 to 2005. With the two chief ministers and government rent-free quarters in Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad, and what not, all kinds of facilities. See, while leaving America, my ex-colleague, a Reddy friend, he returned to India after lived in US. He told Kumar, "You are falling from the stove, in the pan, above pan." Like, suppose you are making a dosa, right, on the pan. If the dosa fall into the fire, what happens? It will totally burn, right? So he is saying, like, this is India and you are going to fall in fire. That is America. I didn't understand that statement when he was telling in airport at that time. But that's fine. Hats off, brother. He's a very good friend, I should say, rather than ex-colleague. And he told when one of the, after PVR Kaprasad sir, another IAS officer took in charge, two more IAS officers took in charge, and I was there. They liked my honesty, and they put me in their cabinet or whatever, the secretary, whatever. And while going to take the charge, that friend told, he was thinking, I mean, he might be cautioning, Kumar, don't get corrupt. In case if you want to get corrupt, don't take, like ambassador car is passion at that time. Maybe there are many modern cars, but so if you want to ask, buy, don't ask one ambassador car. Ask 20. Example is quoting. So if you corrupt, you corrupt like that. Otherwise, don't corrupt. So he finally said is, don't corrupt. That's what, don't corrupt for pretty things. It's a brother. Then I have to see, we are best friends, honest friends, still I have to prove my integrity and not character, integrity to him at a particular juncture, because of the IAS officer did bad things, who took in charge after this PVRK Prasad sir. So then he realized what Kumar is, and then that's a journey of life. And see, I told in one video, Aditya interviewed me, right? Then I said, if I'm honest, I don't need to remember. If I tell lies, I have to remember that lie, and I have to repeat that lie, and then I have to tell 99 more lies to cover that one lie. So I have to make a century, right? Century of lies, rather than life. Yeah, thank you. This is what I would like to communicate. I don't know what you call log, blog, or vlog, whatever. Last 2 weeks I didn't make a video, so I thought of cover these points in 20 minutes. Thank you, God bless you. Yeah, don't approach brokers. That's what my message is for jobs or visas. Thank you. When it comes to COVID-19, outsourcing companies made a lot of profits because there are no buildings, no administrative costs, and all these outsourcing companies, CEOs are Jains, Marwadis, and Tamilians, Chaudhuris. They're all, positively I'm telling, they're all caste or region or religion, but they're all business oriented, economic oriented, right? Business oriented. So they didn't waste money like other Rajus, like such Ramling Raju they dismantled the industry, right? So they are all wasted, dismantled the business. Other business people are not like that. That's one. And sorry, I named it few, but you know the Sachin scam, right? So that's how. And some of it, yeah, they save a lot of money on the administrative expenditure, cost of the building and whatever, no AC, air condition, no coffee, all that cost less. But mainly what I found from the outsourcing companies, international travel. For example, sales team, they travel globally every week or every month to get the projects from various countries, not just US, UAE, Europe and other countries to India outsourcing companies. So the travel cost is saved like anything. So that accumulated lot of money, but outsourcing companies do not show that on the accounts or anywhere on the books. But that's maximum profits or cost cutting saved it. But I also talked to some of the people, friends, they said instead of 9 hours, they are working 14 hours a day, because 2 hours, 2 hours, 4 hours daily in India people spend for travel. That also they are spending it for the work. Work productivity has increased. No vacations, right? Because of work from home. Of course, work from home, not only in US, India also, many companies are not capable of having VPN, Citrix or whatever, providing remote laptops or office desktops, because many people in India may not have laptops and Wi-Fi, right? Wi-Fi on par with the office. So these things, cost establishment one time they did here also in US, and that become blessing in disguise. Another business model has opened is what one of the Indian CEOs who are doing business, stopping H1B hiring, he told like they are doing this kind of business, that as new business has opened because of COVID-19. So you never know how business turn. Like many of the financial institutions here, they never know healthcare industry, they never know what is work from home, because most people come because of the sensitivity of their data. But because of the work from home, somebody has to provide, because their networking team of 3 or fleet of 10 people may not provide everything, right? For example, they have 200k employees. How can 50 network engineers can do everything? So some vendor has to come step in and do these remote VPN connections, networking stuff. So that has opened a new business, because I talked to many people. I should not name them, their designations on the whatever industry also. So that has opened a business. And some people, H1Bs from New Jersey, scammed body shops. They are doing 2 jobs, but employers paying only 1 job also, I heard. Some green card holders I know are doing 2 jobs, 3 jobs. Because work from home, you never know, right? You manage 2 phones, 2 laptops, 3 laptops. But same time, some green card holder friends don't have job yet. US citizens, they don't have a job yet. Some they have whatever, some driving Uber, some may not be driving Uber, whatever. So it is good for some, bad for some. But in India, I heard, I don't remember the number of millions, but 1 crore press. People lost their jobs and, in India. I feel I empathize with them. And some recruiter brothers who fired abruptly by the body shops in US, they contacted me, sir, what to do next? And I told them, don't write online, because they're very young, they have to build a career, right? Because other guy will not hire again. Yeah, this is what. Thank you.